Hey guys, I'm Rija, content manager at HeavyM. So you may have a project in mind. You have your projector, and you know where you want to project your content. But how can you get the best result possible, depending on your environment and the installation you want? Stick around. We'll explain everything in this video. So you know there are three types of projectors around, right? Ultra short throws, and standard throws. Ultra short throw projectors generally all look the same. You can often see them in classrooms or meeting rooms. You can put it on the floor, on the ceiling, or even on the same wall. Short throw projectors are perfect if you want to project images, but don't have lots of space around you. If you want to feel like you're at the movies, but your apartment or your bedroom is not exactly the same size as that of a theater, for example. Standard throw projectors for much more distance than ultra shorts and short throw projectors. For the same lumens number and resolution, standard throw projectors are much cheaper than the other one. It's important to know that there is not one better than the other. They each have their own specificities and each is more adapted to certain given situations and projects. But we'll talk more about that in another video. So let's assume you know what you want. You have your projector and you know where you want to project your content. But say you're not on site. You've never been to the place before. You've only seen it in pictures or in blueprints. How can you make sure that the distance needed between your projector and the projection surface will fit the constraints of the area? Let me introduce you to the formula to be used for every projection mapping project. R equals D divided by B. Thanks to this formula, and by knowing two parameters, you can easily find out what the third parameter is and set up your mapping for an optimal rendering. D is the distance between your projector and the surface you want to project on. B is the image width of your projected image, or the length, either way. In projection mapping, it's actually the bigger side of your image. Both D and B can be in any measure units, feet, centimeters, meters. As for R, it's the throw ratio. The bigger the number, the longer the throw distance. And the further you can get away from your projection surface to have an optimal image. R is defined by the characteristics of your projector's lens. You know R thanks to the types of projectors we mentioned earlier. As their throw ratio is low, less than 0.3, they need to be really close to the projection surface. They're not necessarily the first choice in terms of projection mapping. For example, they're not optimized for three-dimensional surfaces because of the very short throw distance. Take this line ahead. If the projection comes from above, then all the parts below won't be taking any light. This is the typical case when you don't have much distance from the projected surface and have relatively big spaces to cover. There is a maximum throw distance you cannot exceed, otherwise the image won't be of optimum quality and will get pixelated. For standard throw projectors, the throw ratio is superior to 1. It offers much more distance than the other ones. If you don't have any short distance constraints, this is the projector you need. Ours is a short throw lens, 6,000 lumens, up to my projector. So in our case, we have the throw ratio, 0.75. We have the image width, B, which is 2.5 meters. And we want to find out at which distance, D, we can have the best image. Well, easy does it thanks to our formula. So R equals D divided by B. So we have D equals R times B. So D equals 0.75 times 2.5. So we have D equals 1.875. So we know that we need to be at least 1.875 meters away from our projection surface to have the perfect rendering. Short throw projectors generally come in handy for projection mapping. Do use this formula whenever you have a project in mind, and let us know in the comments how well this worked for you. All these advice are especially helpful before you get on site for your prep work, when you start conceiving your project. Everything needs to be fine-tuned and tweaked once you have everything at hand. And there you have it. If you want to know more about the perfect projector for your project and all the settings that you need to take into account, such as luminosity, resolution, or lifespan, well, we have a full guide for that. Be sure to check out the link in the description. And if you like the project we made, we use our super cool Olga kit. Learn more about it in the link in the description. Hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more mapping content. And until next time, stay safe.